Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through C-scan algorithm. So C-scan algorithm, in the previous lecture, it traveled up to 199. Guys, please, if you are reading from my PDF, please note the value. It should not be 200, it should be 199, guys. Okay, so after reaching 199, it should automatically return to 0. So it is in a form of circle. So here it is 0 and beside it only it is 199. So in that way. I hope everyone got a small idea about circular. So for our representation, for our understanding, we'll be just drawing it in a straight line only. Okay, so let us do the algorithm for the example which we are doing from the past 3 videos, I think so. This is our third video on the same topic. Okay, C-scan. So C-scan is nothing but after reaching 199, you will be starting. So initially we'll be drawing 0 to 199, we'll be marking 50. 100, 150, we marked the 3 spots, fine. Okay, so initially he told that he visited 37, after that he visited 53. So in this also we will be assuming the movement as right, and then we will be returning, we will be continuing in that way only. Okay, so here we reached 53, after that the next highest value is 57, after that 98, after that 122, after that 129. So the thing is that once you reached here, after that you will be continuing forward till 199, but you will not stop there. You'll continue back, and like let us assume this, guys. Okay, so this is your cycle or cylinder or whatever you may think. Okay, so here you got 200, sorry 199. After 199 you are directly connecting to the next one, right? So if you assume in this way, this will be better. Okay, so here let us assume in this way, those both are attached. So here after 199 you are directly connected to 0. So is there any need to stop here? You can just continue like that, right? So that is the reason why you will not highlight this. You'll be just continuing to directly to 0. After that the least value is 12, so you'll be stopping at 12. After that 14, fine. After 14 you'll be reaching till 25. After 25 you'll be reaching 47, fine. So again you'll be calculating the differences, but there is a small trick in this calculation. Please do carefully while doing this, guys. Okay, so let us do it. At least for this problem I'll be doing for a single calculation, guys. Okay, so initially we started at 37. Okay, 37, I'll be just covering it if you have a doubt that I'm just seeing and writing. After that we reached to 53 to 57, 57 to 98, 98 to 122, 122 to 129. After that we reached 199, but it's not a direct approach. We reached directly to 12, and then we reached 12 to 14, 14 to 25, 25 to 47. All the calculations will be normal except this calculation, guys, because here we are reaching to a point where it is circular. So this calculation, you need to divide it into two types. That is nothing but 129 minus 12 plus the result which you get from here, 0 minus 12. So it is a mod, so any value will be valid. So you will be getting answer as 83. Fine. So for this particular thing, the value is 83. For rest all things, you will be calculating in the normal way. So we got 210. So it provides a uniform waiting time. So when we compared with the normal scan, this circular scan is far better, guys. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through look scheduling. So look scheduling is nothing but it will be observing the future. I hope everyone got a small idea. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.